गुड मॉर्निंग माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स. सो आई होप एवरीवन इज गुड एंड सेफ एट होम. सो टिल टुडे वी हैव फिनिश्ड थ्री लेसन्स एंड टू पोएम्स. अ टाइगर इन अ हाउस, अ सोल्जर सन्स, अ लेटर फ्रॉम मदर एंड पोएम सेल्फ लेंसेस इफ. सो वी फिनिश दैट मच. So today I am going to take the next lesson, that is The Blind Dog, written by R.K. Narayan. So before going to start the lesson, just do some pre-reading activity task, listening and speaking. Read this passage at home before it is narrated to you in the class. Follow carefully your teacher's narration, then answer her questions. People love animals, her or his questions, okay? People love animals and keep them as pet. Take dog for example. Dogs are well fed, okay, bathed and groomed and taken out for a walk and rides. Their masters get them good medical care. In the end, they are sometimes put asleep and help them escape the pangs of death. There are also people who keep all animals to make them work for them. They feed them well to keep them strong. Have you heard of SPCA, the Society for Prevention of Cruelty to Animals? It says we must not treat animals cruel. In this story, some people help a poor mongrels to run away from its cruel masters, but the poor thing comes back to him and fall into his clutch again. So this lesson is all about the taking care of the animals or pet. That this lesson they have taken example of dog. Reading. Read the story at home before it is read in the class. Follow carefully your teacher's models. Reading and read the story at home and improve your reading ability. Okay. So let's start first one. It was not a very impressive of high class dog. It was one of those commonplace dogs one sees everywhere, colored of white and dust, tail muddled at the young age by God knows whom. Born in the street and bred on the earned and garbage of the marketplace, he had sporting eyes and undistinguished carriage of and needless pugnacity before. Before he was 2 years old, he had earned the scares of the 100 fights of his body. When he needed rest on hot afternoon, he lay curled up under the covert at the eastern gate of the market. In the evening, he set out on his daily rounds, loafed in the surrounding street and lanes, engaged himself in scrimmages, picked up eatables on the roadside, and was back at the market gate by nightfall. So it was all about the dog. Okay, so very impressive. Huh? So it was not high dog. It was not too dog, small dog. It was young. The things. Okay. It is now 2 years old. Okay, has earned to scare. It has running for the food, running for the bread, and moving here and there and getting disturbed by his dog body. This life went on for 3 years, and then occurred a change in his life. A beggar, blind of both eyes, appeared at the marketplace. An old woman laid him up there early in the morning, seated him at the gate, and came up again at middle with the same food, gathered his coins and took him at home night. So okay, in the marketplace there was a beggar used to come daily and sitting in the marketplace with an old man laid him up there only, and after some minutes. She used to come and take that all the coins and took him at the night. The dog was sleeping nearby. He was startled by the smell of the food. He got up, came out of his shelter and stood before the blind man and wagging his tails and gazing expectantly at the blow. And he was eating his fresh meals. The blind man swept his arms about the ask, "Who is there?" At which the dog went up and licked his hands. The blind man stroked its coat gently from the tails and to ear. He said, "What a beautiful you are. Come with me." He threw a handful of food which the dogs ate grateful. It was perhaps an auspicious moment for starting a friendship. They met every day there, and the dog cut off much of its rambling and to sit up beside and a blind man and watches him receive alms morning to evening. In course of time, observing him, the dog understood that the passage by the he must give a coin, and whoever went away without dropping a coin was clashed by the dogs. He tugged the edge of their clothes and pulled them back to the old man at the gate, let go only after sometimes was dropped in his blow. Among those who frequently frequented this place was a village unrich who had been a mischief of devils in the hymn. He liked to tease the blind man by calling him name and by trying to pick up the coins of his blow. So just the dog made a friendship with that beggar man who was sitting in the market. That beggar, dog used to go near to that person and pull his leg. Okay, licked his hands, and he used to play. That dog used to play with the beggar. Then one day the beggar realized that it was maybe some kind of animal. Then he said to that dog, "Yes, could you come with me daily? You are very beautiful, and we can spend lot of time along. We can spend time much here." Then the person said, "Yes, say means dogs. Yes, in the sense, in the not in the words, in barking." Dog said, and so just this was keep on observing by the one person's daily. And he was saying to that place, he was saying, "There's so many people were observing this one." Okay, so next. And by trying to pick up the coin of this of his bowl, the blind man helplessly shouted and cried and whispered his stuff. On Thursday, this boy appeared at the gate carrying on his head a basket loaded with cucumber or plantain. Every Thursday afternoon, it was a crisis in the blind man's life. A seller, bright colored but doubtfully perfumed, with his wares mounted on the wheeled platform, a man was spread out chief story book of the Kanisek. Another man who carried colored ribbons elaborate frames. These were the people who usually gathered under the same arch on the Tuesday, when the young man appeared at the attest gate on them, remarked, "Blind follow, here comes your scourge." Okay, so there was a man used to come and take all the coins, all the foods from, grab the things from him, and he was helpless. That blind man was very helpless, and he was not in situation to take back from that person because he was too old. "Oh God, is this Thursday?" he wailed. He shifted his arms about the cold. "Dog, dog, come here. Where are you?" He made the peculiar noise which brought the dog to his side. He stroked his hand, head, and muttered, "Don't let that little rascal." At this very moment, the boy came up with a leer on his face. face. Okay, so that after that the Thursday that person came and took all the coins on the, so he was supposed to leave that place. That beggar called dog, come here where you are. So this peculiar man, this nonsense, this rascal has taken all the things from me and he is going here. Fifth one, blind man still protesting you have no eyes. If you are really blind, you should not know this either. He stopped this, his hand moving towards the block. The dog sprang on him and snapped his jaws and his voice. The boy extended his hands and ran for his life. A dog bounded up behind him and chased him out of the market. So that person came and took and stolen all the things, and that beggar called to that dog and said, go and catch that person. And the dog did like that only. Yeah, just he listened that beggar voice and just went and followed that person and went into the market. See the mongrel's affections for this old fellow. Okay, marveled the perfume vendor. One evening at the usual time, the old woman failed to turn up and the blind man waited the gate, worrying as the evening grew into night. As he sat fretting there, a night boar came up and said, Sami, don't wait for the old woman. She will not come again. She died this afternoon. It's a very sad moment. Okay. So one evening, usually that blind person was waiting, and it was afternoon, it was in the evening and night also. Just that blind man doesn't know because he doesn't have the eyes to see. Okay, so just he keep on waiting the things, and the one more person came, one girl came and said that you don't have to wait for that girl, that woman, because she died this afternoon only. So this was a very sad news for that said. Okay, so now I would like to read the things once again here. Oh God, is this Thursday? He wailed, he swept his arms about and called, dog, dog, come here, where are you? He made the peculiar noise which brought the dog to his side. He stroked his head and muttered, don't let that little rascal. At this very moment, the boy came up with a leer on his face. Means as soon as the beggar says this word, the dog got angry and shows on this face. Blind man still protecting. You have no eyes. If you are really blind, you should not know this either. He stopped his hand and moving towards the block. That when the person was supposed to snatch the coins or the things from the blind beggar, okay, that beggar was saying, if you don't have the eyes, then you'll come to the pain of the not being eyes. So then again the dog spanned on him and snapped his jaws on his worst. The boy extracted his hand and ran for his life. The dog bounded up behind him and chased him out of the market. That dog followed him into the market. See the mongrel's affection for this old fellow, marveled the perfume vendor. So he was the perfume vendor. By seeing the smell, the beggar said that this is the person again coming on every Thursday and snatching all the things from me. One evening at the usual time, the old woman failed to turn up and the blind man waited at the gate, worried as evening grew into night. As he sat frightened there, a night boar came up and said, Sam, don't wait for this old woman, she will not come again. She died this afternoon. So one day, in the evening, the beggar was waiting for the woman, and it becomes night and dark. That one person came and said, she is not going to come because she died this afternoon only. So students, this is very interesting lesson. So getting more excited to see next one also. So in the next class, we'll see the lesson continuation parts. So thank you so much. See you. Take care.